Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am excited to bring you guys my next video all about being an American in London. Now people usually ask me, after 6 years of living in London, why don't I have a British accent yet? And honestly, my response to that is like, duh, I'm American. But there are a few British phrases that I have picked up after living in London for nearly 6 years, and now instead of saying very American things that I used to say when I first moved to England, I am a little bit more British in some of the sayings and phrases that I do say. And in today's video, I wanted to share with you guys my 10 phrases and words that I now use that are more typically British English rather than American English. For those of you guys that don't know me, hi, hello, how's it going? My name is Anika and I am an American living in London, and I have done tons of videos about my life abroad and what it's like living abroad as an American. I have lived 10 years abroad so far, 4 years in Germany, 6 years in London. But before I babble on about all this in this video, if you guys do want to check out any of my videos all about living abroad, I have an entire playlist that I will link up in the cards for you right now. I know some of you guys call me out in the comments down below that I have too much of a long intro. So without further ado, let's jump into today's video and the top 10 things that I have started saying that are more British than American. So the first thing that I have to share with you guys today is pretty common here, and it's something that I picked up really, really quickly, is where is the toilet, or saying toilet instead of bathroom or restroom. Now, Brits will understand bathroom or restroom, but to be completely honest, when you're in a restaurant or you're at a bar or you're out somewhere, very few people say bathroom or restroom because, yeah, you're not going there to have a bath and you're not going there to have a rest, but you definitely need to use the toilet. So here in England, as well as across most of continental Europe, my experience is that saying where is the toilet is just universally understood. And I know when I say that, when I go back to America, everyone looks at me funny because, again, we say bathroom and restroom. But here in the UK, everyone does use the word toilet more than bathroom or restroom. So that's the first phrase that I picked up. The second phrase that I have picked up is I can't be bothered. And I really love this phrase because honestly, there is no direct translation into American English. It honestly translates to something like, I'm just too lazy and I don't want to do that. So I love that I can just say, I can't be bothered to take out the trash, or I can't be bothered to walk the dog, or whatever the case is. People just like to say, I can't be bothered, and I definitely have started saying that as well. Another thing that Brits do that I had a hard time figuring out is the abbreviation in text or messages saying CBA. And that is another way of saying I can't be bothered, but Brits like to say I can't be asked. And like, I just don't say that, but I know a lot of Brits that do say it. And now whenever I see CBA, I totally know what they're talking about, which is another way of saying I can't be bothered. The third phrase that I picked up is a little bit of a strange one because in American English, it kind of means something totally different. But here, cheers, or the word cheers, means thanks. Or you can say it when you are actually cheersing a glass of wine or beers or whatever. But here, whenever someone like, you know, helps you out or whenever you say thanks, you can also interchange the word thanks with cheers. Now, I was really confused about this one because to be honest, people were saying cheers when you were obviously clinking glasses, but then people said cheers before they hung up the phone, or cheers when someone gave you change back for whatever you paid for. So anyways, here in England and in London, a lot of people will say cheers instead of thanks, and I have now adopted that as well. And usually I will say cheers to people whenever I'm like at the grocery store and someone's handing me my credit card back, or I'm at a restaurant and someone gives me like, you know, my change or the menu or something like that. I'll usually just say cheers. And I don't usually say it that loudly because I'm not super comfortable with it, but I have to say I am saying it more and more rather than saying thanks. The fourth phrase here in England that a lot of Brits do say is to be fair. Now, this is another one of those that doesn't really have a direct translation into American English. So when I started using it, I was using it all the time, and I started saying it so often that I didn't even realize how often I was saying it. And to be fair is usually used whenever you're trying to make a point, or you want to have a counter argument, or you just want to make it clear what you are trying to say. So there's no real direct translation into American English of to be fair, but if I were to kind of explain it to you guys, to be fair basically translates to on the other hand, or to make my point, or something like that. So an example of this is somebody might say, oh, you know what? I don't want to go outside because it's super cloudy today, or it looks like it's going to rain. And I might say, to be fair, it's actually really warm outside, so we should go outside. The fifth phrase that I have picked up that I find absolutely funny, and honestly, I had no idea what this was when Brits were first saying it to me, and it's the phrase, I'm knackered. And I was like, what are you? Are you hungry? Are you, you know, what is that? I'm knackered. And I was like, we have nothing like that in American English, and I never actually heard it before until moving to London. So I'm knackered basically translates to I'm tired. I would actually probably translate it to I'm super, super, super tired, almost I'm exhausted. So for example, if you had a really long day at work, or maybe you did a really hard workout, usually at the end of it, I'm just like, oh, I'm knackered. And it's so funny because I normally say I'm tired, but I realize when I'm really, really tired, I might just say I'm knackered. And I definitely say it more to Brits than I do to Americans, because again, they just understand, and I know Americans would never, but it's one of those phrases that I've definitely started using more often the more tired I get, which is ironic because obviously it's talking about how tired you are. But yep, I'm knackered is one of those phrases that I absolutely love saying now that I live in England. So the sixth phrase that I want to talk to you guys about today that I've adopted here in England is kind of by force, because if I were to say the American word French fries, it is just not as common. Now, obviously, London is a little bit different because there are just so many Americans here. So when you say French fries, and even sometimes you do see French fries on the menu, but most Brits here call fries, or the American version of fries, chips. And when I saw chips on the menu here, I was thinking potato chips, meaning like Lay's chips or Doritos or something like that. But chips here in England means French fries. And more times than not on menus, especially when you go to the pub or certain British restaurants or European restaurants here in London, they will always say chips. And to be very clear, chips are like potato wedges. They're a little bit chunkier, they're a little bit fatter, and it's what we would call a potato wedge fry in the US. But here, chips are just those wedges. And they do sometimes say fries on the menu, but when you see fries on the menu here, it's more like super skinny, or yeah, like McDonald's fries. But chips are just those thicker wedges, and usually on a menu when you see chips, they are talking about French fries. Have you guys learned a new phrase in British or American English in this video? If you have, please make sure to give this video a thumbs up so I know to create more content like this for you guys. Now, my seventh phrase that I say now all the time, that I even say to Americans, is I say the word mate. Now, mate is a translation or direct translation from American English of like friend. But being Californian, I usually say dude. I'm like, hey dude, how's it going dude? What's up dude? Those are typically phrases I would say as an American. But here in England, I will always say, hey mate, how's it going mate? What's up mate? I say mate so much now that I actually accidentally text hey mate to my American friends, and they're usually just laughing because it's obviously very British and not American. Now, the eighth phrase that I have come across that I found, again, really funny, because in British English, this word means one thing, and American English, it means something totally different. And the word or the phrase is, I'm pissed. Now, I'm pissed in British English translates to I'm drunk. So when you say I'm pissed here, okay, people think you're drunk. But obviously in American English, I'm pissed means you're angry or you're upset or you're not happy. But here, when you say I'm pissed, most people are going to take it as, oh, you're drunk, okay? So usually when you're out and you are drinking with your friends, instead of saying, oh my gosh, I'm so drunk, people will be like, oh, I'm pissed, or she's pissed, or he's pissed. Which when I first heard all of that, I was like, why is everyone so angry at each other? Okay, why are we all pissed off at each other? Because really all they're trying to say is that everyone is drunk. And I really was like, I was missing it when I first saw it. I was like, why is everyone saying everyone's angry when everyone's happy and drinking? So anyways, I'm pissed translates to I'm drunk. And I definitely do use that more often now. So the ninth phrase that I started to use a few months after living here is the phrase gone off. Now, whenever you say something has gone off in England, it's like the food has gone bad. For example, if you look at yogurt or milk in the fridge and then it's past its expiry date. For example, whenever you look at yogurt or milk in the refrigerator and you see that it's past its expiry date, you are going to say, oh, that milk is gone off, or the yogurt has gone off. But in American English, we don't say gone off. We usually say it's gone bad, or, you know, it's past its expiry. So I didn't realize I was saying gone off until someone pointed it out to me that gone off is British and not so much American English. So I naturally adopted that phrase. And finally, the 10th phrase that I have definitely picked up and I use now both in England and back in California when I do travel back to California is the queue or queuing up. And I have to say, I never really understood it when I first moved here. I was like, why do you guys say queue instead of line? And everyone in England, it is actually a British thing, okay? Let's just be clear. Brits love queuing. It's like in their blood or their nature to always queue up for everything. So I naturally, obviously, started hearing, oh, there's a queue, or I'm in the queue, or, oh, is that the queue for the checkout, for example? And when you hear it so often, you naturally adopt the word, and I use it now so often because obviously Brits love queuing and you always ask, is there a queue? Are you in the queue? Where's the queue? And when you start saying it that often, the phrase just becomes a part of you. And now when I go back to California or America, I'm always like, oh, are you in the queue? And I swear people look at me like I'm crazy. Because again, Americans don't get that much exposure to British English because we honestly don't have as many British films or TV shows in America the way that England has so much American media here. Other than Harry Potter or the occasional British actor in films, we really don't see it or hear those British phrases. So anyways, those were my 10 phrases that I have picked up while living here in England. Do you guys have any other phrases that are super British or super American? I would love for you to let me know down in the comments down below. I know a lot of people who say, well, English is English, whether it's British, American, Australian, whatever. But to be honest, it's so different. The phrases, the way we use the language is so different, and also the way we spell things are so different. So if you are an American looking to move to London, don't worry, most people will understand you, but you will pick up a lot of new phrases because the English in England use English way differently than us Americans do in America. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys are looking for more content all about being an American in London, that's what my channel is all about. And I would love it if you smash that subscribe button and be a part of my YouTube family and make sure you turn on that bell notification so you know exactly when my next YouTube video is going live. Right, guys, I hope you guys have an amazing day wherever you are in the world, and I hope to catch you guys in my next video. Bye!